Selecting the right core material for your grinding wheels is important because it directly affects the grinding process, machine integrity, and safety. In today's episode of the Grinding Chronicles, we'll examine common wheel body materials, their key physical properties, and how to ensure you're using the appropriate core material for your application.
Welcome to the Grinding Chronicles, presented by CDT Engineering Manager, who we call the Wheel Wizard, also known as Jeff Wirth.
Hi, I'm Jeff Wirth, Engineering Manager at CDT. Today we're going to look at the most common core materials, their properties, and process requirements. The wheel body's main job is to provide structural support so the grinding wheel performs effectively. The wheel body material is an integral part of the grinding wheel towards achieving the grinding performance you need. Common core materials include metals such as steel, aluminum, and copper. There are also cores made from ceramic or resin composites like bakelite, abrasive composites, and carbon fiber. With so many options, how do you choose? At CDT, we consider properties like density, expansion, thermal conductivity, and modulus of elasticity to determine the best material for each application. Let's talk about each of these properties and see how the common core materials compare to one another. Technically, density is mass per unit volume, but it's easiest to think of in terms of weight. As you can see, materials on the right of this graph are very dense and heavy, whereas materials on the left are quite light. Heavier cores constrain machines, so large wheels often need lighter materials. When we talk about expansion, we're talking about growth of the wheel body, which we want to minimize. This can come in two forms, mechanical and thermal. When you're running something at high speed, it wants to grow. That's mechanical expansion. Materials with high tensile strength better resist mechanical expansion. Thermal expansion is growth caused by heat. All grinding applications generate heat, but wheel bodies made with materials with low thermal expansion coefficients grow less, allowing us to achieve tighter tolerances and more consistent performance. With thermal conductivity, we're looking at how efficiently a material transfers heat away from the grind. Materials with low thermal conductivity have better insulating properties, making them less ideal for getting the heat generated from grinding out of the workpiece. Finally, we look at the modulus of elasticity, or MOE. This measures how much a material deflects under force without permanently deforming. Think of a rubber band being stretched. As long as you don't apply too much force, the rubber band will retain its original shape. For applications that need to withstand high grinding forces without deforming, we turn to materials with high MOE. Every core material has its strengths and weaknesses. To design an optimized wheel body, we have to balance material properties, machine limitations, and application requirements along with cost. In fluke grinding and medical drill bits, for example, you're running at traditional speeds. So you got relatively low grinding forces, which mean you're not generating as much expansion or heat. You could ultimately choose from any of the core materials, but based on cost, we would typically suggest a ceramic core because it has the lowest cost while meeting all of your application needs. However, when you're running at high speeds like camshaft grinding, the process generates a lot of heat with extremely demanding grind forces. Some materials like resin composites, softer metals, and ceramic cores can't handle the forces required for this application. You're going to need high stiffness, which means a carbon fiber or a high tensile strength steel core. We can also combine materials to make a combo core, using more than one material that can result in low weight, high stiffness, and toughness without excessive cost. Now that you have a basic understanding of the types, properties, and process requirements of wheel body core materials, you might have specific questions about your particular application. Our engineering team is here to help. Feel free to reach out to the Grinding Chronicles at cdtusa.net.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like, follow, and subscribe button, and get ready to learn something new in another episode from Continental Diamond Tools.